So, Jain to all of you, today we are going to study a very important topic of control system, that is review of stability analysis with respect to S-plane, that is pole locations in S-plane, and then we will study an important method that is called as Routh stability criteria. The stability and Routh criteria. First of all, what do you mean by stability? First of all, I would like to inform you all that we will restrict our discussion to LTI systems only, that is linear time invariant systems. For LTI systems, a system is eventually stable with respect to zero initial conditions. If the response of system is growing or it diverges without bound, then it is termed as unstable. Whereas, if the response of system tends to be of decaying nature, then the system is stable. And if the response is sustained and oscillate around a specific value, then it is called as marginally stable. So, if we plot the response of system, if the response of system is of growing nature, then the system is unstable. If the response of system is of decaying nature, then we term it as stable. Whereas, if the response of system oscillates in a constant bound, then it is termed as marginally stable. So, for LTI systems, we test for two types of stability, that is Bebow stability, bounded input, bounded output stability, and asymptotic stability. Now, if we talk about Bebow stability, that is bounded input, bounded output, for any system, if we give a finite input and the response of system becomes finite, then the system is termed to as Bebow stable. Whereas, if we talk about asymptotic stability, if the response of system is of decaying nature, that is at t tends to infinite, response tends to zero, then the system is termed to be asymptotically stable. So, if we talk about a signal sine wave with finite amplitude within plus minus 1, then the signal is bounded signal. And if the response or output of this system, it will grow with respect to time, then it becomes unbounded and hence unstable. Whereas, this is unstable. Whereas, if the response tends to decrease and at t tends to infinite, it becomes zero, then the system is said to be stable. So, if bounded input yields bounded response, then the system is termed as stable. Whereas, if bounded input yields unbounded response, then the system is termed as unstable. We can also see from this diagram that for bounded input, if the response tends to be unbounded, the system is termed as unstable. Whereas, if we see from previous diagram, a bounded input gives bounded output, so the system is stable. Now, for zero input system, we test for asymptotic stability, as I have already told you. If the response of system decays to zero, as t tends to infinite, then the system is stable. Whereas, if the response of system is exponentially growing, then the system is unstable. So, if we talk about any system, let Rs be the input and Cs be the output, then the output of system can be written as Rs into Gs. Using convolution property, we can say that multiplication, if there is a multiplication is as domain, then there is a convolution in time domain. So, if we use the Laplace transform and convolution property, we can write it as Ct is equal to convolution of Gt into Rt. Or 0 to infinity g tau rt minus tau d tau. this function is finite if the impulse response of system is finite. So the system is Bebo stable if and only if the impulse response of system is integrable as well as finite. Now if we transfer this to the pole locations of the system, we can say that the roots of denominator polynomial, also called as characteristic polynomial, are called as poles, and the location of these poles will determine the stability of system. Whereas the roots of numerator are called as zeros, which are used to define the zero location on S plane. Now consider a system. This is a third order system with denominator polynomial of third order. The zeros are given by roots of s square plus 7s plus 12 equal to 0, whereas poles are given by roots of denominator polynomial, that is this. If we solve this equation, we find out that two zeros are minus 3 and minus 4, and the poles are at 0 and minus 1 plus minus j2. So if we plot this in terms of S plane, minus 1, minus 3 and minus 4 are zeros, z1, z2, and the poles are at this and this location plus 0. So there are three poles, P1, P2 and P3. Since the poles lie in left half of S plane, so this system is stable. So this is the location of three poles, the origin, minus 1 plus minus J2 and two zeros, minus 3 and minus 4. So this is the pole zero map of any system. Now if we talk about the stability or nature of system with respect to pole location, consider a first order system with function a upon s plus a. There is one pole at minus a. And if we plot this system in time domain, the response is of exponential nature, which is decaying nature. So the system is stable. So a first order system with pole location in left half is stable. Consider another system with pole location in right half. So this system is unstable. We can also see this from time domain analysis. The response is a into e to the power at, which is growing nature, though system is unstable. So we can determine the nature or behavior of system from both the time domain as well as transfer function of the system. There are some more examples. Consider a second order system with two poles at a minus a plus minus j beta, that is both the poles in left half of S plane. If we draw the S time domain representation, the response will be exponential plus sinusoidal and of decaying nature, so the system is stable. Whereas if we take the roots at a plus minus j beta, that is right side, then the response will be e to the power at, that is growing nature, and hence the system will be unstable. We can take one more system at s plus minus j beta, that is there are single pair of roots on j omega axis. The response will be sustained and the system is marginally stable. And if there are double pair of roots on imaginary axis, then the response is t into sine theta, that is growing response, and the system will be unstable. If there is single pole at origin, then the response will be constant, that is marginally stable. And if there are multiple roots at origin, then the response will be a straight line, that is unstable. So now we can formulate all these rules, which are commonly called as Routh-Hurwitz criteria. So, how Routh-Hurwitz criteria gives a necessary and sufficient condition to determine the stability of an NTI system. It requires two steps, that is generating a Routh array and interpreting the Routh array for location of poles in S plane to determine the stability of system. We can summarize from the previous slides that if the pole location is on left half of S plane, system is stable. If the pole location is on right half of S plane, system is unstable. And if the pole location is on J omega axis, then if there are non-repeated roots on J omega axis, then the system is marginally stable. And if there are repeated roots on J omega axis, then the system will be unstable. So, we will formulate all these criteria using Routh. So, Routh states that the number of roots of characteristic equation with positive real part, number of roots of characteristic equation with positive real part is equal to number of changes in the sign of first column of Routh array. So, if there are two sign changes in first column, then the system is unstable because two roots have positive real part. You will take it with an example. Consider the characteristic equation as e to the power sn, e to an s to the power n, an minus 1 s to the power n minus 1 plus up to a0. This is called as characteristic equation, that is 1 plus gs hs is equal to 0. Where g is forward path transfer function and h is feedback path transfer function. So, now we will form the Routh array. For this purpose, we will form s to the power n and s to the power n minus 1 row by taking the coefficient of s to the power n and then alternate coefficients. And then for s n minus 1, take the coefficient of an s n minus 1 and then alternate values. So, for s n it is an, an minus 2, an minus 4 up to a0. And for s n minus 1, an minus 1, an minus 3 up to a1. Now, for remaining rows, we will form these rows up to s to the power 0. We will multiply this minus this divided by this. So, an minus 1 into an minus 2 minus an into an minus 3 divided by an minus 1. So, this will form bn minus 1. Similarly, for second value, it is an minus 1 into an minus 4 minus an minus 5 into an divided by an minus 1. So, this will give the third row elements and so on. So, in this way, we form the entire Routh array and then calculate the coefficients for all the Routh arrays. Now, regarding stability, if all the coefficient of first column are of same sign, that is positive, there is no sign change, then the system is stable. And if there is a sign change, then the system is turned out to be unstable. Now, the number of sign changes in the first column will give the number of roots in right half of S plane. So, we will solve this using an example. Consider a system with characteristic equation S cube plus 4S square plus 9S plus 10. So, the first row will be S cube, second row will be S square. The coefficient of S cube row will be 1 and 9 and the coefficient of S square row will be 4 and 10. For next coefficient value will be 4 into 9, 36 minus 10 divided by 4. So, 26 by 4. Next row, 26 into 10 minus 0 divided by this. So, 10. Since the first column is all positive, there is no sign change. So, the system is completely stable. In this way, we calculate the Routh criteria and find out the stability of system. Without Routh criteria also, if we find out the roots of this characteristic equation, it is negative, that is in left half of S plane. So, the system is stable. Now moving towards another question. Consider an example of s cube plus s square plus 3s minus 5. The first row will be s cube and second row will be s square. The coefficient of s cube row will be 1 and 3. And s square row will be 1 and minus 5. And we will find the next element as 3 into 1, 3 minus 5. Minus of minus 5, that is plus 5, 8 divided by 1. And the next value will be 8 multiplied by minus 5 minus 0 divided by 8, so minus 5. Since there is one sign change, so the system is unstable. And since there is only single sign change, so one root is in right half of S plane. The system is unstable. And since there is single or one sign change, which indicates one pole is in right half of S plane. We can also calculate it by the roots. So the roots of previous equation is 1 and minus 1 plus minus J2. So one root is positive, indicating the system is unstable. Now we consider another example. Consider a function s to the power 5 plus s to the power 4 plus 2s cube plus 2s square plus 3s plus 15. So the first row will be s to the power 5, coefficient 1, 2, 3, and second is s to the power 4, 1, 2, and 15. So it is a special case wherein first element of a row is 0, whereas the complete row is not 0. The next element will be 3 minus 15, that is minus 12. So, in this case, there are two methods. Either replace the s with another variable 1 by p and form another polynomial, that is 1 by p to the power 5 plus 1 by p to the power 4 plus 2 1 by p whole cube plus 2 1 by p ka whole square plus 3 into 1 by p plus 15 is equal to 0, and then cross multiply and create another polynomial and then solve, so it will solve the issue. The second method which we use and which the most widely used is replace 0 by a small positive number, say eta, and then find out all the remaining elements of Routh table and then see the sign change and find out the stability. So we will replace this 0 by eta, and then the next element will be calculated 2 zeta minus of minus, yani plus 12 divided by eta. So we will replace this 0 by zeta, and the values will be 2 zeta minus of minus, yani plus 12 divided by zeta. Next element will be 15. You can see this minus 0 divided by zeta. Similarly, for next element, this multiplied by minus 12 minus of 15 zeta divided by this, which comes out to be minus 15 eta square plus 24 eta plus 144 divided by 2 eta plus 12. And the last element will be 15. So we can see that there are, as eta tends to 0, this value turns out to be negative. So there are two sign changes, means system is unstable and two roots are in right half of S plane. Consider another special case wherein a complete row becomes 0. So, consider an example, s cube first row, s square second row, the coefficient of s cube row is 1, 6, and s square row will be 5 and 30. So, the value will be 6, 5, 30 minus 30, that is 0. In this case, we have not reached till s to the power 0 and a row becomes completely 0. So, we will replace the complete zero row by the coefficient of auxiliary polynomial formed by just above row. So, the auxiliary polynomial will be 5s² + 30. We will differentiate this polynomial. So dy ds of as will be 10s, and we will replace the coefficient next row will be by 10 and 0. So the coefficient 5s² + 30, we will differentiate it. So the coefficient will be replaced by 10 and 0. So next we will calculate 30 minus 0. So the coefficient will be 30. Since there are no sign changes in the first column, so system is stable. So what do you mean by an auxiliary polynomial, and what is the importance of auxiliary polynomial? In the previous example, if such a case exists when a complete row becomes zero, it shows that the system may be marginally stable. That is, some of the roots may exist on j omega axis or in right half of S plane. The location of those roots can be found out by auxiliary polynomial. That is, roots of auxiliary polynomial. So if we find out the roots of this polynomial, it becomes s² + 6 = 0, or s = ± j√6. So the location will be j√6 and −j√6. So the system will be marginally stable, not completely stable. So we can say that if there are non-repeated roots on j omega axis, system is marginally stable, whereas if the roots are on right half or repeated roots on j omega axis, system is unstable. We will say this. So the if the there is a existence of auxiliary equation, the auxiliary equation is always an even polynomial, because the complete zero row exists in always an odd numbered row. So this even polynomial will give an imaginary roots. So the roots may be symmetric or real, may be symmetric and imaginary, and may be in two different in other coordinates. So if their roots are symmetric and real, the system will be unstable. If the roots are symmetric and imaginary and non-repeated, system will be stable. And in this case also, if there are the roots are in right half of S plane, system will be unstable. So the auxiliary polynomial will give information about the symmetricity around across origin, and it will also inform about the marginal stability of system. So consider another example. The first two rows are s⁵ and s⁴ with coefficient 1, 2 and 1, and the second row 2, 4 and 2. Next, if we talk about the next row, 2 to the 4 − 4, that is 0, 2 − 2 = 0. So there is an all zero row. So the auxiliary polynomial will be 2s⁴ + 4s² + 2 = 0. We take 2 common, so s⁴ + 2s² + 1 = 0. The coefficient of auxiliary polynomial will become 4s³ + 4s + 0. So the coefficient will be replaced by 4, 4 and 0. So we will form this, divide it by 4, since two elements are same. So it is becomes 1, 1, 0, and then the next value will be 1 × 1 − 1, that is 0. Again 1 × 0, 0, so 0, 0. Again we will form an auxiliary polynomial, that is s² + 1 = 0, and the coefficient will be 2s + 0. Then it is replaced by 2, and the complete Routh table will become like this. Since there is no sign change in first column, it means that there are no poles in right half of S plane, but there may be some planes on j omega axis. To find out the repeated roots on j omega axis, we will find the roots of this auxiliary polynomial. For this auxiliary polynomial, we can write it as x square plus 1 ka whole square is equal to 0, or s is equal to plus minus j plus minus j, that is s square is equal to minus 1, or s is equal to plus minus j. Since there are repeated roots on j omega axis, so system is, there are two roots on j location and two roots on minus j location. So repeated roots on j omega axis, which tells that the system is unstable. So there is no sign change, that is system will have no roots on right half of its plane, but there are repeated roots on j omega axis, which turned out that the system is unstable. So in this case, we have covered all the possible special cases of Routh criteria, find out the absolute stability of any system using Routh criteria, as well as the location of poles on j omega axis. So I hope all Routh criteria is clear to all of you. Now we will continue our lecture series and study root locus in our next lecture. Thank you.